وتأذن ربكم لئن شكرتم لأزيدنكم ولئن كفرتم إن عذابي لشديد. And remember when your Lord proclaimed, if you thank me, I will increase you in your blessings and provisions. But if you are ungrateful and turn away, then the punishment of Allah is severe. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَلَا يَتْرُكُ اللَّهُ بَيْتَ مَدَرٍ وَلَا وَبَرٍ إِلَّا أَدْخَلَهُ اللَّهَ هَذَا الدِّينَ. And there will not be a house made of clay or a tent except that Allah will enter this religion into those houses. Brothers and sisters, look, they predicted the fall of Da'wah Salafiyah. Look around you today. No one can stop it. Salafiyah will never fall. The sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will continue to spread if we hold on to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah azza wa jalla said, tabaraka wa ta'ala, as we find in the Quran, yuriduna liyutfi'u nur Allah biafwahim wallahu mutimmu nurihi walau kariha al-kafirun. They want to put out the light of Allah. They want to extinguish the light of Allah. But Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He will perfect and spread His light even if the disbelievers dislike it, even if the disbelievers they hate it, even if the enemies they despise it. Allah said, هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُظْهِرُوا عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْمُشْرِكُونَ. Allah, He sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with knowledge, with the religion, and with guidance, with knowledge and righteous deeds, and the religion will gain ascendancy and be supreme. No doubt, look around you. They predicted the fall of Salafiyah. Where's this fall? Every year, by the blessing of Allah, in even with our shortcomings, even with our deficiencies, the da'wah continues to spread. I guide you to some trade that will protect you from the punishment of Allah. Listen, brothers and sisters. Holding on to the Quran and the Sunnah with understanding of the Sahaba. Listen at the fruits. Listen at the rewards. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, shall I direct you to some trade, some commerce? It will protect you from the punishment of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Allah, He said, Tu'minuna billahi wa rasulihi wa tujahiduna fi sabilillahi bi anwalikum wa anfusikum. Dhalikum khayrun lakum in kuntum ta'lamun. Believe in Allah, believe in the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and strive in the path of Allah with your own selves, with your money. That's better for you if you only but understood. Believe in Allah, believe in the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Strive al-Islam with your own selves. Don't say, what can Islam do for me? What can you do for Islam? What can you do to spread the sunnah? Allah azza wa jalla said, listen at the rewards. If you hold on to the Quran and the Sunnah with understanding of the Salaf and you remain firm upon it and you die upon it, and Allah Azza wa Jalla blesses you to die upon Tawheed and the Sunnah, may Allah bless us all to die upon Tawheed and the Sunnah. We ask Allah for paradise and we ask Him to protect us from the hellfire. Ikhwan, listen what's at stake. That's why Instagram attacks will take it. Facebook attacks will take it. Personal attacks will take it. Why? Because listen what's at stake. Do you think by an Instagram account, by an anonymous Facebook account, by a Twitter tweet, that the people are going to leave this sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Allah said, tabaraka wa ta'ala, yaghfir lakum dhunubakum wa yudkhilkum jannatin tajri min tahtiha al-anhar wa masakin tayyibatan fi jannati 'adan dhalika al-fawz al-'azim. If you cling to the Quran, if you cling to the sunnah, if you believe in Allah, if you believe in the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you strive in the path of Allah, if you strive with yourselves and with your wealth, Allah will forgive you your sins. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. Allah will forgive you of your sins. We need the forgiveness of Allah. Allah will enter you into the gardens of paradise. Allah will give you houses in Jannah. And that's true success. That's success. When somebody leaves this world and we say, do you know brother so-and-so? He died upon Islam and the Sunnah and upon righteousness. Do you know sister so-and-so? They died upon Islam and the Sunnah. That is success. The one who wants to go party into the nightclub, may Allah guide us and them after Ramadan. May Allah guide them. The one who is happy that Ramadan is over so that they can go back to the disobedience of Allah. May Allah guide them and us. They haven't understood this blessing, brothers and sisters. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِّعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Every blessing that comes to you is from Allah. Then Allah said, brothers and sisters, the rewards for believing in Allah, the reward for believing in the Messenger of Allah, the reward for holding on to the Quran, the reward for holding on to the Sunnah. Like we said, here you are in America, in Philadelphia, implementing the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wallahi alladhi la ilaha illahu. We have visitors coming from overseas. When they come to the masjid and they pray with you, wallahi, they leave with praise. They say, we pray in many masajid and we don't see the sunnah implemented like that. The way that the people pray, the way that they join their ranks, the way that they have a love for the sunnah. Don't let anyone put you down. Don't let anyone try and humiliate you. Wallahi, by the Lord of the Kaaba, the blessings of Allah upon each and every one of us are many. Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us, tabaraka wa ta'ala, some of the fruits of this in the dunya, how Allah will reward you. He said, وَأُخْرَى تُحِبُّونَهَا نَصْرٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَتْحٌ قَرِيبٌ وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And in this world, if you believe in Allah, if you believe in the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, if you strive for Allah with your own selves, if you strive for Allah with your money and with your wealth, Allah will give you another blessing. What is that? Allah will aid you. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will give you imminent victory. Don't worry. Shaykhuna Shaykh Muqbil rahimahullah, he used to say, look, today the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is zahir and naqiyya. It is still present. It is still being implemented. It is still preserved. But the heads of misguidance and innovation have passed away. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Every blessing that you have is from Allah. And the greatest blessing, brothers and sisters, is that Allah guided you to Islam. Allah guided you to the Sunnah. And Allah guided you, tabaraka wa ta'ala, to try and fear Him as He deserves to be feared. And we'll close with this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that comes in Sahih Muslim. Upon the authority of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu an, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا مِن نَبِيٍ بَعَثَهُ اللَّهُ فِي أُمَّةٍ قَبْلِي إلا كان له من أمتي حواريين وأصحاب. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, there was not a prophet before me except that from his nation he had disciples and companions. يأخذون بسنته, they would take the sunnah of that prophet. ويقتدون بأمره, and they would follow his command. ثم إنها تخلف من بعدهم خلوف, but there will come after them generations. Now, brothers and sisters, don't think that you will not be trialed, that you will not be tested. They came after those prophets, generations. يَقُولُونَ مَا لَا يَفْعَلُونَ وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا لَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. They used to say what they did not do. And they used to do what they were not commanded. Listen what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said. How do we deal with those who oppose the haqq? What we find in the Quran and the Sunnah with the understanding of the Sahaba. Now we invite them, we give them da'wah. We never compromise. Listen what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said. And this was about the followers of every prophet. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, as for those who go astray, he said, فَمَنْ جَاهَدَهُمْ بِيَدِي فَأُمُؤْمِنِ. Whoever strives against them with his hand, he is a believer. وَمَنْ جَاهَدَهُمْ بِلِسَانِي فَأُمُؤْمِنِ. Whoever strives against them with his tongue, he is a believer. وَمَنْ جَاهَدَهُمْ بِقَلْبِي فَأُمُؤْمِنِ. Whoever strives against them with their heart, then they are a believer. وَلَيْسَ وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ حَبَّةُ خَرْدَلِ. And after that, you don't even have a mustard seed of faith. That is why it is impossible for the believer that fears Allah and hopes for the last day to forsake the people of the sunnah, to abandon the people of the sunnah. Alhamdulillah, Allah Azza wa Jalla has blessed us, brothers and sisters. And we thank Allah for these blessings because gratitude is linked to an increase. But if we're ungrateful, then know that the punishment of Allah is severe. Alhamdulillah, the brothers have gone out of their way and the sisters to organize activities for you for the rest of the day. May Allah Azza wa Jalla bless each and every one of them and all those that contributed. So alhamdulillah, today, brothers and sisters, is a day of enjoyment. It is a day of eating. It is a day of drinking. It is a day of enjoyment, however lawful enjoyment, in that which is halal. Don't return back after Ramadan to anything from disobedience. Rather, alhamdulillah, the good that you developed and you built, walillah alhamd, throughout this month, continue for the rest of the year. And may Allah bless us to continue for the rest of our life. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.